happy you could be with us. Before our announcements, we want Daniel to sing a song to get us in the spirit. Are you hearing me okay, everybody? No? It's kind of a, let's crank it up, Jimmy. Crank it up. Crank it up. They're saying nice and loud. All right, we're going to hear it. Daniel sing a song. It's called Easter Song. That's going to welcome the Holy Spirit. Amen.
If you know the song or you learn it while I'm singing it, feel free to sing. You might have heard it. It's in the book somewhere.
Hear the bells ringing, they're singing that we can be born again.
Hear the bells ringing, they're singing Christ is risen from the dead.
The angel upon the tombstone said he is risen, just as he said. Quickly now, go tell his disciples that Jesus Christ is no longer dead. Joy to the world, he is risen. Hallelujah, he's risen.
Around us, and they are ministering Jesus's power. Quickly now,
reach out and receive it, for this could be your glorious hour.
Joy to the world, he is risen. Hallelujah, he's risen. Hallelujah, he's risen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Stone said he is risen, just as he said. Quickly now,
reach out and receive it, that Jesus Christ is no longer dead. Joy to the world, he is risen. Hallelujah, he's risen.
John, it's good to see you and those who are watching online. What a joy that you're here. We hope you can stay after church. I don't know if you saw in the solarium, some goodies are out there for us to partake of, and it's beautifully decorated. Thank you to all those that are putting on the coffee hour this morning. And we have an Easter egg hunt. Amen? Woo! There's plenty of eggs for everybody, so Kids can, after the service, meet outside the solarium doors, and I'll kick off the Easter egg hunt, and we're going to make sure the little ones begin first. No chaos Easter egg hunts. We're going to let the little ones go first, but there's plenty of eggs for everyone to take part. What a beautiful day. Can I hear an egg? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We had a spectacular sunrise service this morning. My brother said it was a little long, but otherwise, no. Oh, it was just beautiful to just look at everything. What was that?
He didn't say a little long.
He didn't say a little long. No, I'm kidding. Sorry, he doesn't mean a God. No, I'm kidding. Anyways, no, what a beautiful day. The sun is shining so bright. The birds are singing. And we're here to celebrate our risen Lord. Really, there's not a lot of announcements. I did want to lift up. Yesterday, we packaged 10,000 meals through the outreach program. We met with the Kiwanis Club at Mashpee at the Coombe School. And we did like an assembly line of 10,000 meals, macaroni and cheese and apple cinnamon oatmeal. And I think it was just a wonderful, wonderful time. I wanted to lift that up. We actually have 6 boxes of them in our office ready to go to area food pantries. Amen? And so let's remember everyone. The flowers this morning, we have the flowers. And think of those who might be facing the first Easter without a loved one. We want to lift them up, help them believe in the resurrection. So it is a joy. My job is to help you open your heart to the Holy Spirit and realize that the gates of heaven have been opened wide as we celebrate the resurrection. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Amen. Turn to your neighbor, smile, and pass the peace. Pass the peace of our Savior, Jesus. Peace of the Lord be with you. Welcome. Brother Dan, peace of Christ. Amen. Peace of the Lord in the balcony. Peace of Christ be with you. Amen. And everybody watching online, peace of Christ. Amen. Please stand with me. Let's join together in the call to worship. It's found in our program from Psalm 118. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. He is risen. He is risen indeed. The Lord has won the victory. Our Savior lives, and we are made alive through his love. The stone's been rolled away. This good news is for all people. He is risen. He is risen. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Let's join together. We'll sing 4 verses. Christ the Lord is risen today.
Christ the Lord is risen today. Raise your joy and triumph high.
We'll make sure this is nice and loud. Casey actually helped yesterday. That was a lot of fun, wasn't it? When we did the food packaging, thinking of the hungry, thinking the area of food pantry. But I asked Casey yesterday, I said, Casey, could you do a blessing, a little Easter prayer for us on Sunday morning? And he said, absolutely. Well, you didn't say that exactly.
All I gotta say is
he said yes.
All I have to say is that when I went over there, it was a big hand help, and I did not do anything when I got there. I was just sitting there doing nothing. But I did have three teenagers that were helping me, and that was really good help, and I moved from place to place. And I guess I was famous.
I was famous. Let's hear for Casey here. Let's hear for Casey. All right, Casey. So I'm going to give you the mic. You're going to make sure, we might make sure the mic's up, nice and up, but speak right into it. And just whatever the Lord moves you to pray for us today on this Easter Sunday, okay? Whatever you want to pray, all right?
Here you go.
Can I have everybody put out their hands and close their eyes? If you don't want to, that is fine. But all I will say is that thank you, God, for doing what you have done to help everybody here today and everybody that has been praying for everybody. And thank you for rising from the dead and coming and knowing that Easter Sunday is what everybody wants to dream about and what everybody should be doing and dreaming about. And all I will say is that everybody here, God is with you. Amen.
Amen. Amen, amen. Thank you, Casey. Praise God. All right, that's the prayer. That's the opening prayer. And now we need the kids to come down. All the kids can take part. We're going to sing Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Herb, you know this song, all right? So all the kids come on down. And kids in the congregation, even if you don't know the song, that's okay. Come down anyways. And you guys can stand right where you are. Stand up. All right, let's put those over there. All right, we're going to split up, little left, little right. And we have some signs for everybody. And so we got a pinwheel. Elliot's got a pinwheel. Hold it up high. Amen. He is risen. All right, so we got a song, and I think the congregation's invited to sing along, right, Kim? All right, you're invited to sing along. And so this side is Praise Ye the Lord, and this side is Hallelujah, 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 Praise Ye the Lord. It's pretty simple. Then it's Praise Ye the Lord, Hallelujah, Praise Ye the Lord, Hallelujah, Praise Ye the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord. All right. So we're ready. Daniel, we ready? All right.
Hallelujah. 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 Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Have a seat. We're going to go get a friend right over here. And he's excited about Easter. And his name is Noah. And he wants to join. Oh! Lincoln, can you come help? Can you help me with my rabbit ears? Can you help me with my rabbit? Lincoln, thank you so much. I can hear you now, God. I got big ears, don't I? Happy Easter, everybody! Noah, so happy to see you. Do you like Easter? I love Easter. All the chocolate and the jelly beans that you can eat, and then you take some Pepto-Bismol. So that's what Easter is all about. It's about finding as many eggs as you can find and eating all the chocolate and eating jelly beans and Peeps. I love the Peeps. I can eat so many of them. You know, if you put them in the microwave, the Peeps really get bigger. This is falling off again. Can you take that, Lincoln? Why don't you wear that for me? Can you put that on for me? There we go. So Noah. Hey, Pastor John, what does the Easter Bunny say before he eats? What does the Easter Bunny say before he eats? Let us pray. Get it? Let us? And why'd the chicken cross the road?
To get to the other side.
To find his Peeps. All right, Noah. So, Noah, is Easter really all about just candy and flowers and eggs? I mean, those are nice things. What's Easter really all about? Well, let me think. Oh, yeah, it's about Jesus rising from the dead. Exactly. I keep forgetting that it's all about Jesus, that the stone was rolled away and that the angel sat on the stone and the angel had a big smile and Jesus was risen. Mary looked inside, and he wasn't there. He's alive. That's wonderful that you believe that, Noah. You know what, Pastor John? Some of my friends make fun of me that I believe in Jesus. You know, I have a friend named Trevor that says, "You really believe that stuff? That's nothing. That's baloney. That's nonsense." Really? That's too bad that Trevor says that. But, you know, maybe he can come to believe someday. I don't know. Trevor's kind of mean. Well, even those who didn't believe, some of them are now the biggest believers. So, you know, do you like Trevor? Well, he's okay. Last week, I gave him some of my lunch because he forgot his. So, you know, I'm working on him. Maybe someday he'll come to church. Maybe someday he'll believe. Well, we're here to celebrate that Jesus is alive. Look at all these wonderful people that are here today. This is wonderful. I love that I can see Jesus in you. I can see Jesus in you, Elliot. What's that, Elliot?
I got peeps in my Easter basket.
You got peeps in your Easter basket? Pizza? Peeps. Okay, peeps. Sorry. I guess Noah needs his rabbit ears. But you know what, Noah? The kids are going to sing another song. And it's about Noah in his ark. You need an ark? I know a guy. Get it? So we're going to sing a song, and I think, Noah, do you know this song? I think I know it. It's called Rise and Shine, right? Yes, it's called Rise and Shine. Let's stand up, and let's sing together another song. And we have it on the screen, so everybody gets to sing along. Amen? Let's sing along. We have the lyrics right there. I can see them. Give God the glory. All right, guys. Come on, Jimmy, you gotta sing. Ready, Lincoln? All right, can you see the words up there? Let's sing together. And you can clap where you need to clap, all right?
Rise and shine, give God the glory, glory, rise and shine, give God the glory. Those children.
You know what I learned yesterday when we were at the food packaging? Jimmy and Ryan, did you learn that? There was a woman there by the name of Eleanor. She had been to Israel, Noah, and she learned a Hebrew word for cool and great. And it's called sababa. Can everybody say sababa?
Sababa.
That's a Hebrew word for great or cool. And you learn that today. Amen. Let's pray, because the resurrection is what is so sababa. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for all these kids and for Noah. And we thank you for the Easter egg hunt for our families. We thank you for feeding hungry people. We thank you for you coming to us and loving us and forgiving us and giving us life. Help us be filled with joy today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Take care, guys. I'll see you at the Easter egg hunt. Have fun at Sunday school. Let's hear it for the kids again. Let's clap. Children of the Lord. Of the Lord. Woo! That's going to stick right in your head for the rest of your day, at least today. Amen. Sharon's going to lead us in our prayer confession. That's in our bulletin. Amen.
Okay, please join me in the prayer of confession. Loving God, we confess that at times we do not share in the joy of the resurrection, but are caught in the worries of the world. We confess that
we do not always live in the spirit of new life, but remain discontent, grumbling, and anxious.
Forgive us for not living out and not sharing the good news of a risen Lord. Forgive our lack of enthusiasm and tendency towards apathy. Call us back to your ways, O God, to seek hope, reconciliation, restoration, peace, and new life.
We confess we have neglected to live as people who believe in the resurrection. We have been selfish and self-seeking and have not lived out the gospel message. Free us from the weight of this world. So we can live as people who believe in your life-giving, amazing grace. In the name of the risen Christ, we pray. Amen.
And the assurance of forgiveness. Christ is risen. The stone is rolled away. The tomb found empty. Mary calls out, I have seen the Lord. We have seen Christ, too, in every helping hand, in every heartfelt gift, in every choice to restore life in this world. We are called to this new life, a life of forgiveness and reconciliation. You are forgiven. Accept your forgiveness and know that God loves you and desires great joy for your life. Walk forward on this journey of faith, knowing your brothers and sisters are with you. Amen.
Amen. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank you for your Easter offering this morning, and I pray that you give out of joy and that you give knowing that your offering will transform lives. You see all the kids, amen? We want them to feel at home here and feel loved. Whatever age you might be, amen. George, I met a guy yesterday. His name was Dave. He's a member of the Kiwanis Club. He was 100 years old. I sat with him. There's a picture of him and me on the Facebook page if you want to see him. So he sends his best because I talked all about you, George. George is 99 years old and in his 100th year, praise God. And so children from a little baby all the way up to George and David. Amen. We want you to know your love. So thank you for your offering. As the ushers pass the plate, the choir is going to join in with an anthem, "He is Risen." Join together in the doxology. It's on page 95 if you don't know it. And let's present our offering to God. Please stand if you're able as we sing and present our offering to God. Most holy and gracious Lord, accept these gifts, we beseech thee, and understand that we give you along with them our hearts and our souls and our lives, that together they may continue to strengthen your holy church here in Austerville and around the world. Amen. Amen. Let's join together in the next hymn, and it's Up From the Grave, He Rose. Amen. He arose. Please come forward. We have a wonderful outreach and missions team, and really you're all members of that committee. You didn't know that. But Patty's going to come up and read. You're going to sit right there? Okay. We can do that, and I can turn this mic on. You can just take this. Patty Morrell. Everyone on the outreach team is named Patty for some reason. No, I'm kidding. But Patty's going to share a word and read. About how Christ is alive through us. Amen.
Good morning, church.
Well, let's make sure the mic is on, though.
I don't hear it, huh?
Yeah. Let's... Is it going? Do say test, test.
Test, test.
There we go. That's better.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Happy Easter. The outreach committee has been asked to do a mission minute this morning to celebrate how the risen Lord is with us through mission. Jesus' mission continues today through ordinary believers like all of us at Osterville Church. The risen Jesus is at the center of the numerous ministries our church supports as the hands and feet of Christ. Your prayers, your support, and your service to the homeless veterans on Cape Cod, to the vulnerable people in shelters like Champ Homes and Safe Harbor in Hyannis, to the under-resourced parents at a baby center. All are extensions of Jesus' work. This coming Tuesday, when people in our church will be making sandwiches and desserts for Miracle Kitchen, our risen Jesus will be working through them. Just as he will be working through the volunteers from our congregation who will be serving the lunch and sharing Jesus' love with the guests at the Salvation Army that day. The risen Jesus is there when you are knitting and praying over your prayer shawls. The risen Jesus is there when you are buying school supplies for needy local students. The risen Jesus is there when you are grocery shopping for your family, but you stop and buy spaghetti and canned vegetables for our food pantry. The risen Jesus is there when you are contributing money to make sure the vulnerable and sometimes forgotten people in our community are remembered at Christmas time with gift cards. The risen Jesus is right here. Right here, when you are making your offering, part of which reaches across the ocean to help strengthen families in Sierra Leone, West Africa. Jesus' ministry continues today through ordinary believers like you and me, filled with the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. We clap. Thank you. Thank you, Patty. Amen. Amen. Now, Ben's going to sing a song in honor of all of you today who are present. And its title is Rise and Shine, but it's a little bit different. And Ben has known Raffi. You know Raffi, the great children's singer? Kim was like, yes, I love Raffi. Ben actually knows Raffi, and yeah, he knows him, met him. I'll say he's a good friend. And so, Ben, tell us about this song before you sing it.
This is a different version of Rise and Shine. It talks about how children and adults live around the world and how God brings the sun every time, and that's how the song goes. Rise with the bluebird shine like the sun. Now's the time to rise and shine. Rise and shine. The world's been turning and everyone is waking. Rise and shine. On this new day, the morning light is waking. So rise with the rest of us, shine like a pearl. Rise and show your love all around the world. Oh, rise with the bluebird, shine like the sun. Now's the time to rise and shine. Rise and shine. Today is calling and this is what it's saying. Rise and shine. Your friends are waking. It's time for work and playing. So rise with the rest of us, shine like a pearl. Rise and show your love all around the world. Oh, rise with the bluebird, shine like the sun. Now's the time to rise and shine. Now's the time to rise and shine.
Yeah. Amen, amen.
Okay, our first scripture this morning is Philippians 3, chapter 3, verses 7 through 14. But whatever were gains to me, I now consider loss for sake of Christ. What is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteous that comes from God on the basis of faith. I want to know Christ, yes, to know the power of his resurrection and participation in his sufferings, becoming like him in his death, and so somehow attaining to the resurrection from the dead.
Amen. Thank you, Sharon. Amen, amen. And then the story of the resurrection from Matthew, Matthew 28. Hear these words. After the Sabbath, at dawn, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and, going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He is risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, 'He has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you.' So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them. 'Greetings,' he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, 'Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me.'" This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable unto you, O Lord, our strength, our rock, and our Redeemer. Amen. 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 So we had that sunrise service this morning. It was spectacular. Some of you were there. I'm counting you. You guys get double credit for being there and here, no matter how long it was. But I was there at 6 early, then at 6:30 a.m. It just hit me that 6:30 is my favorite a.m. is my favorite time of day, hands down. You have to understand the joke. The clock, the hands of the clock, hands down. Both hands are down at 6:30. All right. So I have a better one. Jimmy told us one yesterday to me, and I checked with some people about whether I should share this in church. And there's someone else here named Emmy, and she said, "Absolutely, tell this joke." No, I'm kidding. I just think laughter is a tangible evidence of hope. That's my quote. I'm staying with it, right? Because when the angel came down from heaven to do his job, right, rolling away the stone and sitting on the stone, right, I just think he's sitting there and he's smiling and he's laughing. Who is he laughing at? The devil, who thought the devil had won. Amen? And so when you laugh, you have this hope that things are going to get better. And so I tell you this joke on this Easter morning. What car does a belly button drive? What car does a belly button drive? An Audi. So silly, it's good. So just think of that angel laughing and that the gates of heaven are open. The gates of heaven are open because Jesus did what he said he was going to do. That's what the angel said, just like he said. Amen? And we celebrate all these years later because we know the risen Lord. I'm pointing my head and my heart. We know the risen Lord. And today I ask you to make the decision to get to know Jesus. You might know of him, you might not know him.
See the difference there? Knowing of Jesus or knowing Jesus. Paul, today in Philippians 3 that Sharon read today, all I want to know is Jesus and the power of his resurrection. Amen? Amen? We spend our whole life trying to know people, right? You know, this week someone tried to scam people within the church saying they were me. Emails and texts. I maybe say, show a hand if Reverend John Wesley Taylor sent you a text. Kim got it. Needing help. Did you get it? All right, Pam got it. They didn't fall for it because it was signed or closed with Reverend John Wesley Taylor, which I am Pastor John. Kim is PJ. So we know each other. Amen. When you get to know someone, it makes all the difference, right? You know them, you trust them, you love them, they love you. And it's the same with Jesus in the relationship with the power of the resurrection. So today, I want you to think about the atheists that are gathering in Philadelphia. Every Easter weekend, the American Atheist Convention meets since the year I was born, 1963. 61 years of them coming together and saying, we don't believe in God. It reminds me of that person who said to me, Pastor John, I'm an atheist. I don't believe in God. Swear to God. I don't believe in God. Swear to God. And that person changed their tune and they came to believe in God. Amen. So I want you to think about, you know, atheists make a decision to say, not agnostic. Maybe there's a God, maybe not. There are those who say there is no God. We're here to say there is a God. Amen. And it's a God of life that's overcome death, that's overcome sin. He's won the victory over hopelessness and sadness, amen? And gives us purpose and peace. I had a dog once, kind of like Grace, who was at church this morning, who ran up and tried to eat some of the communion bread, which was okay, but we had Grace there, amen? And Grace loves to chase the ball and stick all day long, amen? I had a dog, a Springer Spaniel, that sprung through the tall grass and would all day chase the ball or a stick. And I remember clearly one time I had a big, long stick like this, and I swung it like this, and it perfectly broke perfectly in half. And one went that way, and one went that way, and a dog has to make decisions. I don't know which way he went, left or right, I don't know, but he picked one. And he came back and he brought it to me, his master. We have to make the decision to believe. Doesn't mean that you don't have struggles or doubts or hardship or pain or difficulty, but you believe. You believe in a God that created you to be in relationship with God. Amen? Someone in our church is somewhat new. Within the last year, he's coming to church. And just last week, he shared with me, there were 3 years not that long ago that I stopped going to church, stopped praying, stopped believing. And that person said, they were three tough years. It didn't work. That person's with us in our community of faith. And also, after that conversation, he says, Pastor John, I'm feeling this strange, peculiar feeling that's coming over me. It's washing over me. And I'm like leaning in, wondering what he's saying. He says, I think it's happiness because he's so close to Jesus. He knows Jesus. So today I want you to think about how important it is to know Jesus and the power of the resurrection. You know, that first Easter long ago, they kept telling the story over and over. And I think it's interesting that the first witnesses of the resurrection were women, and the men didn't believe them. They went and told the men, we saw the Lord, he's alive. And it says in Luke 24 that all the disciples said, nah, that's nonsense. Literally, that word is in the Bible. So the lesson I'm learning is listen to women. They know what they're talking about. Amen. Right, Claire? Praise God. And listen to people who are witnesses to the resurrection. Today, it's he is risen. It's not he was risen. He is risen in our hearts, in our lives. If we believe, God Jesus lives inside of us. Amen. Mary Beth and I, do you know we've only known each other for a year and a half? And we're madly in love now. And I'll tell you why. It's because when we met on match.com, we typed in Christian, believer, loves Jesus. And so we met for coffee. What did we talk about? We talked about God and Jesus, the Holy Spirit and church, and how wonderful it is to know Jesus. It's number one. Both of us suffered difficult divorces. All divorces are difficult, but heartbreaking. We were in a tomb, but we never gave up. Never gave up that love wins. There could be someone here right now, they're hurting. They don't know if they're loved, but they are. You got to have faith. And so I wanted to lift up that it was at Joshua's Pond that I asked Mary Beth to marry me, and I gave her a ring, and she gave me this Bible. The duct tape Bible is retired. It's over there. It's still here among us in church if you haven't seen it before, but I upgraded. I upgraded from this Bible that was worn out, and it's held together, falling apart, and Mary Beth saw that and says, you need a new Bible. So I got a new Bible, and I got a new life. Amen. And a new wife. No, that rhymes. Sorry. But I love how Paul says, I press on to the goal, right? I don't give up. He says, I consider everything a loss compared to the surpassing worth of knowing Jesus, my Lord. I want to know Christ. Yes, to know the power of his resurrection, and also participate in his sufferings, becoming like him in his death, and so somehow attaining to the resurrection from the dead. I press on to my goal. Amen. Anywhere you are in the spectrum of faith, just keep at it. Don't give up. The stone's been rolled away. That angel is sitting on that stone with the biggest smile, kind of like Matthew last week, who witnessed to us, testified through Adult and Teen Challenge. If you were here, there were all these men, hard-scrabbled, tattooed guys that were just praising God because of their sobriety, and not just that they're not drinking or using, but they know Jesus in the power of his resurrection. And Matthew, who was one of the leaders afterwards, told me, he said, when I first did heroin, it was like falling in love. But my love for Christ and his love for me is greater than heroin. Can I hear an amen? So nothing compares to knowing Christ and the power of his resurrection. And so I want you to look around right now. Find someone you know. Literally, look them in the eyes. I'm going to look at my mom. Because I think of the resurrection when I think of a year ago right now, where she was in her physical health, and all of your prayers and your love and your cards. She's doing so amazing today, and she'll tell you it's because she never gave up faith. Amen? But she knows, and I know, there'll be a day that we'll lay our head down and we'll breathe our last, right? When my dad was preaching right here, he died, it'll be 30 years ago this August. He died suddenly at the age of 61. Some of you knew him. He was a much better preacher than I ever was. But I remember the year before he died, maybe 2 years, he said that a man in his late 80s all of a sudden started coming to church. And my dad was curious. He said, why now? And the man said, final exams. And so I tell you, there's no time to waste. Start the journey of faith today. Start the journey of knowing Christ by coming and joining with us and walking in the path of life, trusting in God's word, trusting in the Holy Spirit, trusting in others as you look around now and look them in the eyes. There are people who believe, people who have believed for years and years, people who have just accepted Christ as their Savior, people that know that their Redeemer lives. And I ask those who are going to dance to come up, Camille and Brendan, and Pastor Rebecca is going to lead a sacred dance right now. And you're going to hear a beautiful song. And it's, I Know My Redeemer Lives. And you know there's an eclipse coming up, right? April 8th.
I think we're going to get 89% of the sun blocked out, right? People are traveling to different places, but I want you to know one verse here. It says, the very same God that spins things in orbit runs to the weary, the worn, and the weak. And the same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken, they conquered death to bring me victory. Hear these words. Watch the movements. Open your hearts to know Jesus.
And some of you I know have seen sacred dance before. For those of you who haven't, it is a way to worship with movement to song. And it uses a variety of different movements. And sometimes it is American Sign Language. And so for this particular song, you will hear when it talks about my Redeemer being Jesus Christ and the Amen. Sign language for Jesus is this.
Amen.
Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? And who told the ocean you can only come this far?
Amen, amen. Thank you, thank you. Amen. Wow, I know my Redeemer lives, and I testified. I hope you can do the same. Doesn't mean everything's perfect in your life. You have hardship, you have difficulties, but you are in a relationship. If you so decide to do that and accept. So our prayer time, I want you to think about how powerful a name is. Has anybody said the wrong name to you at some point in your life? I've been called Herb half of my life because of my brother Herb. And he answers to John, I answer to Herb. But I want you to think about how powerful it is. John 20, Mary Beth read that scripture this morning at the sunrise service when Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and she heard someone stole the body of Jesus. And so she was grieving and she thought Jesus was the gardener. He says, why are you crying? She says, I'm trying to find his body so I can attend to it. Can you please tell me where it is? And then Jesus just said her name. That's it. I hope you can hear Jesus say your name today. Because if we want to get to know God, we have to fully understand and believe that God knows us personally. Amen? How important it is. Right, Sharon? Right, Claire? Right, Fran? Right, Laura? Amen. Right, Lois? Herb, Sarah, Mary Beth, the Howe family front row right there, just to know that God loves you personally, wherever you are right now. So let's bow our heads and let's have a moment of prayer. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we ask you to bless our Easter gathering as we go forth, as we sing, because he lives, I can face tomorrow, because I know my Savior lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Thank you, God, for the gift of faith, the gift of the Holy Spirit, your presence and power. And help us to just desire you more than anything. All I want to know is Jesus and the power of the resurrection. Lord, help us set that as a goal in our own lives every single day. That people could see the risen Lord in us, that we would be so filled with the Spirit of Jesus that people would come to believe that their Redeemer lives. And so we ask you to bless all of our prayers this morning for the gift of life, the gift of salvation. All this we lift to you with great faith as we pray together your prayer, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. I forgot to lift up one sermon illustration, and I'm going to do it right now as we get ready to sing, Because He Lives. How many people have a dog or a cat, right? How many people have a rescue animal that you rescue? Who rescued who, right? Amen? Well, there was a little girl that wanted a dog, wanted a puppy, and they went to an animal shelter. And there wasn't any puppies. There was only a handful of dogs. And there was an old dog that had never had a forever home. And this little girl met eyes with that dog. He had all gray whiskers. And they looked at each other. And all of a sudden, his tail that had not wagged for a long time just started to wag. And the little girl said, That's the one, Daddy. That's the one I want, the one with the happy ending. Amen. Let's stand now and let's sing together, Because He Lives. Amen. Because He Lives. Page 364. You have a forever home. Amen. Amen.
God sent His Son.
They called him Jesus.
Page 364.
He came to love, heal, and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives.
Sing it out, sing it out.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth the living just because he lives. How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy he gives. But greater still, the calm assurance this child can face uncertain days, because he lives.
Amen, amen.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know and life is worth the living just because he lives. And then one day I'll cross the river, I'll fight life's fight, no war or with pain. But then as death gives way to victory, I'll see the lights of glory and I'll know he reigns.
Amen. Sing it out.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth the living just because he
out today to be really alive, alive in the Spirit, alive in your love. We praise you, God, that we know that our Redeemer lives. Send us forth in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Happy Easter, everyone.